The following podcast has been rated listener MA. It contains strong language, violence, adult situations, nudity. Listener discretion is advised.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the Laughing on the Sideline podcast. I am your host, Scotty Gurman, a.k.a. Scooter McFuckstick.
Boom.
And alongside me, as usual, I have two excellent stand-up comedians. First, the 1984 Kingman County T-Ball Defensive Player of the Year Award winner, Mr. Jeremy Joseph.
Hello, Scott.
Hey, dude. How's it going?
That's a dumb fucking question, Scotty. I am goddamn gorgeous. That's how I am.
Spectacular. And also the wreck himself, Mr. Derek Alders.
Hey.
Hi. Welcome everybody back to the show. If this is your first time listening to the show, if you haven't already noticed, yes, this is an adult podcast. It is also a comedy podcast about the current events that are going on in sports.
Not the kind of adult he's talking about, though. It's comedy. He's talking about fucking.
No.
We're not going to do that this time.
None of us. We're not. It's not going to be human centipede up in here. We're not doing that.
This is not last week. Live in the now, folks.
Right. Mm-hmm. But it is a comedy podcast. Also, this, like I said, is an adult podcast with foul language. So if you don't like foul language, you're in the wrong place. Get the fuck out of here. Okay. And as usual,
sometimes we talk about poop.
That would make it a children's podcast.
That's one of those words that makes me laugh no matter what.
It is.
It can be. You can be in the middle of doing anything.
I think any time that you can get the same letter to start with and then and two O's in the middle, like boob,
yeah.
Funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, as we always do, we like to start off with our week recap. We go over what we did over the last week. Jeremy?
I fought in Vietnam. that wasn't last week.
I believe the name of that restaurant's Vietnam Nom.
Yes.
Yeah. That is an actual restaurant.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he fought in Vietnam Nom.
Uh-huh.
His pho was cold and
it sure as fuck was.
It went down.
I do not care for that. I mean, I'll eat it, but I'm not paying full price. No, I did a stand-up show.
Nice. How'd it go? It
went pretty well.
Good.
That venue, whenever all this shit gets straightened out, that's going to be a really nice venue. I wish it was closer to Wichita, but it's a really good, cool room to play in. Had a great meal. Katie made this. It was bratwurst macaroni with beer cheese.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, jeez. Fuck, it was good.
Yeah.
And pretzel rolls. Oh, fuck.
Did she make those donut things, the beignets or whatever?
No, she made a couple different kinds of cakes.
Sweet.
Yeah, it was. Very sweet.
Yeah.
Chocolate and something else.
Mm-hmm. Did you like the green room in there? Did you get it? Did you go in there?
Sure, I did.
What? No?
No.
Shit, they had a green room with it was like open bar, whiskey, and everything for the comics and...
Oh, yeah, that I did.
Yeah, I mean, you sat back there, and then there was, like, a couple of VIPs that were back there. And
yeah, Justin Timberlake was there.
Yeah. Damn, you got Timberlake? I just got Bieber.
Yeah.
Fuck Bieber.
Yeah.
He ain't even that cool.
No, he's not. Isn't he Canadian, too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Fuck that guy. Fuck him in every hole he's got.
Hey, easy. I'm half Canadian.
No kidding. Hey. We have Canadian listeners, too.
Yeah, I'm half Canadian.
Those guys are cool. Our Canadian listeners are awesome.
Well, they won't be after. If they listen to the last couple episodes, I have not been kind to Canada.
That's okay. They probably think it's funny.
You should love Canada.
They don't have humor. Why should I love Canada? Just because it reminds me how great I am?
Because they gave us Letterkenny.
That is totally true.
Yeah.
That
blasphemy.
Wonderful.
That I completely agree. Letterkenny changed my entire outlook on Canadians.
If there was an American version of Letterkenny, it would be so much better.
There was. It was called Trailer Park Boys.
and it wasn't near as good.
I never watched it. But,
exactly.
Exactly.
Well, I've also wasted a lot of money on Hulu.
Oh, yeah?
Thanks to Letterkenny, because that's all I've ever watched on there. So that's how Canada fucks you over. My Hulu money is probably paying for their health care. But no, for the first time ever in a show, I told the fucking Christmas party T-ball story.
Oh yeah,
really? And it went very, very well. they enjoyed it. But yeah, the whole set went really well. There was one gal there who had a whole lot of trailer park in her that didn't know how to behave in public, but
yeah, but she cooked a great meal.
She sure did. She
cooked a wonderful meal.
Boy, I would like to know Katie Getty, by the way, who you would never, by the way she was dressed, you would never trust her with anything you would eat. I don't, she looked like one of the village people fucked another one of the village people.
Did she have like the cowboy or the police looking hat?
Yeah. Yeah,
she had that on when I had
So basically she looked like the village people.
Only far more flamboyant even.
Yeah.
And a little more gay.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it was like the fucking village people all became vampires. It was a little weird, but still, everybody did great. It was a good show. Had a lot of fun. Then yesterday, I went to the dentist. You remember when I broke a tooth on a Skittle?
Yes.
Yeah.
What meth will do to you, Jeremy.
It sure will.
Makes them soft.
So will Skittles, apparently. Because I, as you can tell, yeah, by the looks of me, it's either Skittles or meth. Which one do I eat a lot of? I'm guessing Skittles.
I don't think you eat meth, Jeremy.
Well, that shows you how much of it I do. So anyway, they put a temporary crown on there. Well, yesterday I went to the dentist to get the permanent one put on, and they had to like grind on a little bit to get it to fit in there, right?
I fucking hate that shit.
Well, they didn't do it in my mouth. They did it outside.
It's the noise. It's the noise.
Oh, I love that noise.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck, dude. That's like my ASMR. I fall asleep to it.
Oh, fuck. Oh, no.
Yeah, I love that smell. Anyways, they put it in my tooth just to fit it, and they're like, okay, now bite down, and I bit down. Broke the fucking crown right in half, so they had to put the temporary back on.
Oh my
and
God.
I gotta wait another goddamn 3 weeks
for
the new crown to come in.
Way to go, Doc.
I guess it's better finding out then than now or later.
Yeah,
when I'm walking around with exposed nerve from the tooth they shaved down.
Yikes!
And both times, okay. I guess back there on that tooth, there's if you don't put in the lidocaine just right, they can get your tongue. There's like a vein that goes into your tongue, and it makes like this horrible sharp shooting pain up your tongue, and then your whole tongue goes numb. Both times she's gotten that fucking thing. That's what you get for going to a woman doctor. Huh?
Speaking of which, did you see the text message I sent out of our followers, the percentages now?
Mm-hmm.
We got gals following us now.
Mm-hmm.
Gals. Wow.
Ladies.
Yeah. Do we have any dames, Scotty? Any dames?
I don't want to call them what we normally call them.
Yeah.
Women?
Broads.
Women is what I usually like to use.
Oh, yeah. That's totally better.
But, Jeremy, I have a question. You think that...
I've got answers.
With that crown, do you think the rest of your teeth are like, look at this fucking jackass. He thinks he's king of the mouth. Got
probably.
A crown on and everything.
Well, I had her shape the top of it like Jughead's hat in the Archie comics.
It makes me wonder if he's like, you know, this is just my temporary crown. I'm getting fitted for the real, yeah, like whatever, asshole. Take that Burger King crown the fuck off your head. And then all of a sudden he's like, well, I had my real crown, but it broke. Oh, yeah, I'm sure it did. Logical story, you fucking liar.
Because all the rest of my teeth were Long John Silver's hats.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, it really doesn't fit in with the motif of my mouth. But
the royal court of Jeremy's mouth.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
But that's pretty much everything of note that happened to me. Oh, and I keep finding new ways to tear up my garage that might keep pissing my wife off. I took down my pegboard, which I know that was your favorite board, Scotty.
That's the one I usually gets bent over to get pegged on.
Uh-huh. And I went totally against my better judgment and all my morality, and I put up a French cleat wall, which anything French, no.
You should have put up a French tickler wall.
Yeah, I should have. Yeah,
Scotty would have been very happy to have that pegboard replaced with a French tickler wall.
I went with the cleat instead, and I think I'm going to be happier that I did that. It's going to hold my tools better than the tickler. It won't feel as good, but it'll hold shit up better.
Oh,
garage is still all torn to shit, like for the last 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Because I keep finding new shit to build.
Yeah. I actually had a interesting week. I have a work story.
What about Derek?
Oh, we're gonna get to him. He normally is the crescendo. He's the closer.
No, not usually. I'm second.
You're the main act.
I did one fucking French thing, and now you can speak all kinds of foreign languages.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. No, thank you, Scotty. Keep it in English where it belongs.
Yeah.
All right, fine. I'll go last. Yeah. You go. Fine.
No, I want to hear your
Let's go. Let's hear it.
Okay. Italian bullshit.
Amazing story that you got here.
So I got a work story.
Keep it falsetto, though, Scotty.
Fuck
that's
you. Luckily, it wasn't me, and I'm not going to tell you where I work or what I do, but it is in the customer service field.
Excitement video, glory hole number 3. I'll tell them.
Thanks.
North glory hole.
Yeah.
NGH.
Yeah.
So I think that, well, I'll get there. All right. An elderly gentleman came into work a couple of days ago.
Okay, motherfucker, I had to get a new tire.
No.
We talked about this last week.
Not you. This gentleman was probably in his mid-80s, mid to late 80s. How he was driving a vehicle, I have no fucking idea. Started when he walked in, and we have a pretty big, you know, showroom or whatever you want to call it, but all of a sudden, one of my coworkers noticed that the back of his pants were wet, or darker. And there was something that was coming out of the pant legs of his pants.
Sure, he didn't just have two-tone pants?
Yes.
Those are big with the old folk.
Two-tone pants. We're positive.
Okay.
Obviously, you know, what that mess was, made his way to one bathroom and absolutely destroyed it. And I mean destroyed it. I don't mean the slang terminology. I mean there was shit on the walls.
Nice.
I mean, it was that bad.
You don't suppose he had like a colostomy bag that was full?
I don't have any idea. I wouldn't be the least bit surprised. However, and you can tell the gentleman was old enough to where he probably wasn't all 100% there.
Thank God he was driving.
What percent would you think he was?
Huh?
What percentage would you say?
Percentage of what?
There.
Oh,
Jesus.
I didn't really talk to the guy. I just kind of saw
the whole thing. Well, then how do you know he wasn't 100%?
He shit his pants, that's why.
Well, because where he decided...
I've done that in the right frame of mind. That's... Sometimes you just want to leave a dinner party.
I tend to shit my pants and then go to a car dealership. Yes. That's what I do.
I like to do. You want to tell me to buy this car and you're not going to give me my keys? Now, you're going to ban me.
Not to mention, we have two buildings where I work, and that other building is 400 yards away. This gentleman decided to leave the building that I was at, walk 400 yards down to the other building.
That's a quarter mile.
Do the exact same thing that he did in the first building in the second building.
He shit blew his pants two times?
Shit his pants and blew up that bathroom too.
You have a serial shitter. You
got a serial shitter on the loose. I hope he's doing better. Hope he can contain himself.
Really? I wouldn't wish wonderful things on that man.
Yeah.
I'd be like, God, you know, shit all over the fucking bathroom.
Yep.
I hope he has a good day.
Yeah. You come to my house and shit all over the place. I'm not wishing you a good day.
So yeah, therefore, we required Derek's services, so we called him and he came and cleaned it up.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Well, wow. Apparently that's true. Yeah. I guess we like to lie here on the laughing on the sidelines.
We haven't really told the truth yet.
Yeah. Oh, I tell the truth every episode.
Really?
At least once.
Okay. At least one time, yeah.
Oh, when you wish bad shit on people
at the
end?
That's exactly when I tell the truth.
Yeah, you mean that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, Scotty, why is there a tampon on the ceiling? Is that yours?
No, it's not mine.
That ain't stuck there with the panty adhesive either.
No, it is not.
Anyways. Yeah.
Great. All right. That was the most interesting thing on my week. Go, Derek, go.
What'd I do?
Yeah, what'd you do?
I went to Kansas City this week.
Hey, how'd that go?
I went good. I went to see my dad. I hadn't seen him in about 9 months. So
Jesus Christ, really?
Did you have a baby? Was he pregnant?
That's exact. I was pregnant.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I had. So I finally aborted it. Oh my God. One of those late termers, you know. They say better late than never. So
by that you mean you tossed it in the Missouri River?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yep. In Oklahoma, that's called baptizing. Mm-hmm. So I did that, and then, I didn't really do a whole lot. I found out we were driving on the way there, and my wife's like, my tire pressure light's on. I said, well, maybe we should check the tire pressure. No, it's been on for a few days. I think it's just because it got chilly out. It's fine. Yeah. My tires look okay. I'm like, all right. I just got done working 10 hours. I'm fucking tired. I'm like, whatever. So we get to Kansas City, and we're getting ready to leave to come back, and I'm like, her tire pressure light's still on. I kind of take a walk around. She's got like 12 PSI in her front left tire. So we go to air it up. Of course, in the middle of a fucking rainstorm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I'm wetter than Scotty's sister's puss. fucking trying to air this fucking tire up. We get
you
it back.
You think that's what was all over that old man?
Might have been.
It was just the goo from that?
He might have just dove in head first.
Probably.
Oh, my God.
That would make sense.
Yeah. Oh, that's
if it so smelled gross. Bad, yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So a couple of stops to air the tire up, and we made it back. But she actually, I told her, I was like, "Don't you ever fucking ignore that light again."
Yes,
that could have caused a blowout.
That's there for a reason.
Yeah.
Your tire is gradually going down typically, and it won't go back off if once it comes on, they don't air themselves back up.
No.
You at least need to get somewhere and air it up.
Yeah. And well, I mean, all right, I don't want to get into it. Never mind. But anything else happened for your week?
We drank last night.
We sure did. How'd we do?
I did pretty good. I kicked your ass in darts
3 times, but I beat you last time.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah, that last game, I was like, I need 3 bullseyes. That's the only way I'm gonna win here. 1, 2, 3. You motherfucker.
He really did.
Made me feel really good about myself.
Yep.
So and I got the patio laid.
Yeah. It looks nice. Yeah,
take it out, get it drunk, and
had sex with the ground.
Nice.
Yeah, all up in that shit.
There you
still
go.
In there. Yeah, it's record.
It's got some real staying power. Yeah. It's a lot of stamina on that.
It does.
Yeah, you didn't do any golfing this weekend?
Man, I never fucking golf.
I know.
I like chicks.
Thanks, dude.
So. I noticed you sent me the picture of that port. That's a big fucking porch.
It is.
Yeah.
The patio. It's a lot of concrete.
Yeah. So I'm pretty excited about it. We actually went out and sat out there and had some drinks last night and
smoked a cigar.
He did. I did.
I got to smoke a cigar on Derek's porch. I was the first one to do it.
Patio.
Whatever.
You guys enjoy that?
What's
that? Cigar.
I love cigars.
You do actually like it. You're not just doing it to be doing it.
No.
I have tried smoking cigars, finding pleasure in it. I cannot. I just.
Not like it can't be like a Swisher Sweet or a fucking
no. I've bought $20 cigars.
That's
before,
what I'm talking about. That's
and
my
I
shit.
Just
that's my shit.
It makes me feel dizzy and nauseous, and I just makes my mouth taste bad. Everything about it, I don't care for it.
I promise you, I will get you good cigars, and we.
I don't want one. I've had
I swear
good cigars. I could buy better cigars than you could ever buy.
I'm a picky some bitch though. I have to have a particular cut of cigar. It has to be a Churchill cut, or else I won't smoke it.
I keep 4 Cubans living in my basement in that heavily watered garden that I got down there, growing tobacco and rolling my own cigars, and I can't smoke any one of them because I don't like it. Now I got 4 Cubans, and I don't know what to do with them.
Bring them the fuck over. I will take care of that shit.
Scotty's the way you take care of your dogs. You couldn't take care of Cubans, Scotty.
Scotty's nice. Very fucking particular about shit like that. He's got to have the Churchill cut for a steak. He has to have a ribeye. He needs to have a man circumcised. I mean, he's very specific about the cut.
Well, that's why you got him that nice Jewish man's
exactly, and he doesn't even hang it up anymore. I think he's just too busy jacking off to it. All the months are stuck shut.
Probably.
Thanks, Derek. God, you're an asshole. Anyway, all right. Well, believe it or not, this is actually a sports show. Well, at least it's a comedy show. It's centered around sports. We got to get to some kind of sports that's going on at least right now. Here's my favorite thing of the day. As of today, the word jabroni is now officially a word. It's on dictionary.com, made famous by not just The Rock, but I guess some other
the
wrestler.
The paper and the scissors.
No.
It's no, all that smack talk after you play.
The Iron Sheik apparently said it all the time,
too. Oh, yeah,
too.
He did. Yeah.
So it's now a word, and it means, and it's a noun, a stupid, foolish...
Cunt? Is that what you're getting ready to say? I think he was going to drop the C-bomb.
I was. And then I'm just a loser is what it said. And it said...
it doesn't start with a C.
Enhancement talent or a jobber, a wrestler whose purpose is to lose matches to headliner wrestlers in order to build up the status of or the fame of the headliner.
Oh, they actually call out wrestling in the word jabroni.
What?
They actually call that out in the definition, wrestling.
Yes, they actually do. So it's actually a word.
My whole thing is it didn't need to be on dictionary.com. It was a word when The Rock said it. That made it a word. That's
right.
Yeah, he's invented tons of words.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They had a pretty cool piece about him, though. He apparently in his office, he got sent all of the XFL helmets because now he owns or his organization.
I would hope so. He owns all that shit.
Well, but he took a picture of him, but his most cherished possession, I guess, is in the background of the picture.
Is that picture with me?
No.
That autograph picture Jeremy Joseph has got? Yeah. It makes sense.
No, it's the
He never asked me to send it to him, but I sent him several.
So whenever he got cut from the CFL, he had $7 in his pocket, and he still has the 5 and 2 ones that he has framed behind him. I thought that was pretty cool.
He got cut from the CFL? Yeah. He's been a pretty shitty football player.
He played for the Hurricanes. I mean, he couldn't have been that bad.
If he's in the CFL, he's
that bad. He was very highly recruited at Miami. Mm-hmm. He apparently had all the natural tools, but just never could quite develop them.
Yeah, I guess so. All right.
He just couldn't smell what was cooking.
Mm-mm. So the NBA playoffs.
Turns out it was still.
The NBA playoffs are still going on, and our Raptors are probably going to get beat out by the Celtics, but that's okay. But the other day, there was a digital fan, a chick, in the background of one of their digital fans.
They like to be called broad, Scotty.
Yes. Yeah, okay. Sorry. Flashed the camera, and nobody caught it until after the fact.
Nice.
Great.
Cheer her the fuck on.
Sure.
Come on, get a little bit more pumped up for that.
You know how many digital titties I've seen, Scotty? Not even over the course of them, just this week.
They're all pixelated and stuff like that.
I have absolutely gotta get 4K. Zero.
4K?
I don't know how many windows I have open on my phone, but at least 140 of them are to digital titties. I mean, that's why I've always said the deal with cheerleaders. There was a time when tits and ass was a rare thing to see,
mm-hmm.
and girls in short skirts and low cut shit was all scandalous. Fucking tits and ass are everywhere now.
Yeah,
there you have. That is so tame compared to the fucking debauchery that we have unfettered access to.
I see it every time I look in the bathroom mirror.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I got a long enough dick I can actually titty fuck myself. It's.
Is it in the dresser drawer?
It doesn't feel good upstairs, but down. Oh, yeah, it's great.
That's disgusting.
It sure is, uh-huh. Especially when I just pearl necklace myself.
Oh, that's gross. All right.
Sure is.
But yeah, that's all I have in the NBA. Major League Baseball, as of August 30th, Adam Wainwright turned 39 years old, and on that day, he threw a 122-pitch complete game, allowing only 4 hits, 9 Ks, 2 earned runs, and also that was Yadier Molina's 2,000th game as a Cardinal. Go Redbirds, baby.
Woo!
Okay.
They won it with that again.
Fucking deal. Current MLB update. The Royals are currently getting the shit kicked out of them. 5-0 in the second inning, giving up 2 home runs, and 1 in each of the innings. Thank God for Matt Harvey.
It ain't over yet. That's close.
How many games has fucking Adam Wainwright missed?
What do you mean?
Well, that's why he's still pitching at 39. At he's missed like 5 seasons.
Yeah, he only pitches like every 5th one.
And he's injured every year.
Yeah, he's fucking 39.
He's like Julio Franco, but fucking broken.
No, he's like,
what he is.
He's like Bartolo Colon, only he's skinny.
No, yeah. Colon pitched.
And Wainwright can fucking hit,
too. Wainwright missed a shitload of games.
Well, he did. He does get hurt.
All the time.
But that's still fucking amazing. 122 pitches, 39 years old, gets a big W.
Eh,
I mean, come on.
I'm not amazed.
That's because you're a fucking Cub fan.
I'm not amazed at all.
Well, and the Cardinals are only like, what, 14 games into their season?
No, they're back up there. They're at like, I think they're at 30.
Well, yeah, and most of their games are shortened.
Here's what's amazing.
7-inning games, you're right. Yeah.
The Chicago Cubs.
Huh?
All three starting outfielders hit 2 home runs in the same game. So 6 home runs, 2 from left field, 2 from right field, 2 from center field. Each one of those outfielders hit 2 home runs. And it's the first time in MLB history that's been done.
Schwarber,
Hayward, and Ian Happ. Mm-hmm.
And we were talking about this, we saw Ian Happ's first home run.
Yeah, in his debut
at Busch Stadium where the Cardinals beat the Cubs.
Mm.
Just a quick update, the Royals are still getting the shit kicked out of them. Right there at beautiful Kauffman Stadium.
They're only 8 games behind.
They're down by 5 runs. I don't care about overall records. They're not going to win the division.
Oh. Yeah.
Ooh, oh, yeah, they got him.
Got you slipping, bitch.
That's great for the audio listener.
Yeah, don't ever slide past second base, you fucking
idiot. Yeah, don't run so hard, you jack off. Slow it down. No hustle.
Another fun thing that happened in baseball.
I'll be the judge of whether it's fun or not.
Okay,
tell what it is.
Okay. So a cardboard cutout
And so far, fun.
Love cardboard.
Fell from the top of the Green Monster in Boston.
Okay, you're still good. You're still good.
To the ground.
That's how ashamed it was of the cheating scandal. Wow.
Couldn't take it anymore.
Just couldn't. And only it's only 30 feet high, so it wouldn't even die from that. It would just break its legs.
I don't know. You could die from that.
If you head first.
He fell head first. The cutout fell head first.
Well, then he did the only honorable thing.
Well, you know, I know they send you a baseball if the ball hits your seat. Now I think they got to send somebody to kill that guy. That's what's going to happen.
Now, did it fall on a player?
No, but a player had to go and retrieve the sign.
Now, okay, if the cardboard cutout falls on a player, do they have to send that fan to the player?
No, that fan
does he get to keep him?
He's like allowed to come to the game, only he has to be naked and do it again, streaking.
Okay,
that's the equivalent.
I think they should just mail him to the player.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
If your cardboard cutout,
they should mail the player to him.
Yeah, they should mail the player to him. That's what I think they should happen.
Well, if the player would have hit him, but he hit the player.
Okay. I get it.
Turnabout is fair play, guys. It works both ways. Double-edged sword. Baseball's just funny that way.
Yeah. Here's another one.
Marlins guy behind the home plate if you need him.
He's at every single Royals game.
Yeah.
And
he's about season tickets, yeah.
I think so, yeah. Let's see. August 25th, White Sox pitcher Lucas Giolito throws the very first no-fan no-no. That's actually not true. That's actually not true. The Marlins did it a couple years ago.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah, just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, because nobody goes to Marlins games. Is that where you're getting there?
A little bit, yeah.
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 Really? Did you rent that truck? Or
there's a honk. A honking. That's my favorite joke that we have on TikTok. The truck one.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah. That was great.
I hate that one.
Thanks, man.
Now. I used to love it until just now.
Thanks, Jeremy.
Absolutely.
You got anything else? I'm just.
Are we talking? Are we talking TikTok? Do we have a theme song for that? We should. Talking TikTok.
Talking TikTok.
Because I wanted to respond to a fan.
Oh yeah.
Who made a comment on one of our TikToks?
Okay.
Where I had stated the scientific fact.
Okay.
About how women can't have orgasms.
Yeah.
And she comes on there with this bullshit of, no, we can have multiple orgasms. I don't recall her name.
I don't either, but I know what you're
talking about, yeah.
Okay, just like we didn't land on the moon and the earth is flat, whatever, okay? I know for a fact, as a married man, I've had sex at least a half dozen times in the last Jewish calendar year. Nice Jewish male calendars. And so I can state for a fact, no, women cannot have orgasms. And because I am a happily married man, we'll never find this out. But if I weren't, I would happily take that woman into the back of my shagging wagon and show her what it means to not have an orgasm. We can count how many times you don't come, hon.
Oh, God. Thanks, Jeremy. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.
Okay, moving on. The NFL season kicks off next week.
Mm-hmm.
9 days. I think it's 9 days.
Is it just me, or is this maybe the least excited?
Up? Yeah.
Yeah.
When you said that before the show, that it's the weekend after this, football season starts, I'm like, fucking really?
Yeah.
It just doesn't seem possible. I mean, my months are all thrown off with the baseball season not having gone anyway.
Yeah, I'm the same way.
But... yeah, it just doesn't hardly seem possible, and it seems like there's no buildup around it.
No.
So many players are holding out, and they're not holding out, but opting out.
Do you think it also may have something to do with the budget as well? Because they're not going to have as much revenue, because they're not going to be selling tickets and, you know, everything like that.
They sell a shitload of merch still, though.
I'm sure they do. But
I'm actually surprised that there hasn't been more hype with, like, TV commercials and stuff like that.
That's what I mean. I haven't seen very many.
Yeah, and that's what I'm wondering. How are they not trying to compensate for that revenue?
Exactly.
With merchandise sales and advertising and all that shit.
I'm the same way. But there's a part of me that thinks that they're not, because how much confidence do you have that they're going to make it through? whole season?
I'll feel a lot better if they make it all the way through the baseball season.
I don't think the baseball season we're going to have a problem.
Well, if they make it all the way through that, then I don't think football is going to have a problem. But I don't know. It's really hard to say.
Baseball, you have double headers. You can't really do that in football.
You play on the bye week.
Yeah.
Yeah. But still, it's you know, I keep hearing news anyway that they're pretty close to a vaccination, which I got to think that once that happens and is readily available, things got to start getting back to normal. They don't really have an excuse not. I mean, some people are going to opt not to get it, but that's kind of on them.
Yeah, sure.
At that point,
I want 5 of them.
5?
Yeah,
you'll die.
No,
I don't think so.
I think you get 5 of them, you'll die.
No, you just space it out, Scott.
Just one. Wow. Monday.
I don't want them all at the same time. For fuck's sake.
I thought you were talking about them all the time.
No, it's not a pack of cigarettes. You don't smoke them all at once. It's a fucking vaccination.
He's going Monday through Friday, and then he takes the weekend off.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Every day.
Every day.
But Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, okay.
And sometimes on holidays, like Bastille Day, no vaccine.
That's a callback. Good one.
It is?
Yeah.
All right.
I think so.
That's French.
No, that was
Boxing Day.
Boxing Day was the one I was thinking of.
That's whenever you beat your wife. No. The day after Christmas.
No. Oh.
Yeah.
It's actually British Canadian, but whatever.
Yeah. She makes you breakfast, then you knock the shit out of her, and then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. How about the Jacksonville Jaguars?
How about them Jaguars? Woo!
Releasing Leonard Fournette.
That's your boy.
I've had him for the last 2 years, and I regret it.
I don't understand it. Not your regret. I get that. I don't know why you don't regret more things.
I do.
Seems like your life should just be nothing but regret.
It is.
I feel sorry every for minute. The guy. I really do.
I do too.
Because
he's a kick-ass dude. He's a very nice guy.
Not that his name's Leonard.
Yeah.
I mean, for fuck's sake.
How do you not go with Lynn or Lenny?
He goes by Lenny, I think.
I'd go by anything else.
Yeah.
I'd go by Scooter McFuckstick before I went by Leonard.
Scooter McFuckstick Fournette.
Yeah.
Make it all one word.
What a horrible first name. And, and to anybody named Leonard that's listening, change your name. Just change it.
No, don't do that. It could be worse.
Oh, man. Leonard sounds like the guy that's probably the name of the guy that went into your bathroom at work and just shit all over the fucking place. Probably just smeared big L's all over the fucking stall doors.
I like to think that old guy was just laughing his ass off the whole time. It wasn't even an accident. He was doing it on purpose.
Probably.
Just that fucking guy at the customer service desk. Fuck him.
When you get to that age, don't you just kind of not give a fuck?
I don't know.
Oh, I can't wait till I get the age where I can flip off kids.
And you can't get in trouble for it.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I can flip off kids now, but I mean, whenever just like, oh, he's just old. I can't wait for that.
Yeah.
I'm waiting my whole life for this.
I know.
I had to, as harshly as I could possibly get away with, because I almost got into it with my neighbors, scold one of their kids who they have a daughter who has absolutely zero boundaries, who keeps wanting to come into my garage when I'm working out there. And like,
oh, no. You know,
I got saws and power tools and shit. I mean, no. I can't watch that and her.
Work naked. That'll solve that.
Yeah, it would.
No, I don't think so.
It'll solve that problem. It'll create a couple more problems. Yeah. But
like we've seen.
Sorry, I do my best work in the nude. Have you seen my tool bench?
We have looked up before and like out at the front door, the glass door, and she'll be like standing there like looking in our house.
Oh, that's fucking creepy.
Where are your fucking parents? But anyways, I was...
Why do you not take advantage of those spirit Halloween stores? You could scare the living shit out of that kid.
If I knew she was coming... I mean, we've told her, you know, you got to go back home. She's like 5. But anyways, the other day I was working on some shit and was getting really frustrated because nothing was working out. And she comes over and I just go, you have to go back home. Now. you got to go. And... I guess her dad heard me.
Oh, fuck that
and
guy.
Came over and he's like, you know, if she's a problem, just let me know. You don't got to get upset with her. And I said, well, yeah, you can hear me sawing on stuff out here. This is dangerous stuff. I don't want her to get hurt and I don't want to get hurt because I got to watch her and wind up sawing my fucking finger off or whatever. And
I lost a ball doing that.
He works in construction, so you would think he would know better. But it's like, dude's outside and letting her just come over to my fucking chop house.
Yeah.
Because that's what I'm doing. I'm cutting up cars in there.
Nice.
I thought you were gonna say bodies.
I was getting ready to say the same thing.
Regular H.H. Holmes over here.
Yeah. Guys, that's fucking gross. Come on now, clean it up. So the we don't talk about shit like that on this show. Yeah, we talked about throwing a baby in the Missouri River, but
we don't talk about shitting all over yourself in public.
We didn't talk about cutting it up. God.
Right.
Guys are fucking weird.
Also, apparently, as of today, the New Orleans Saints are open to trading Alvin Kamara.
Okay.
What the fuck?
I don't know if that's a bad idea.
High value?
Well, you go back to Clinton Portis in Denver.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody thought Denver was fucking stupid for letting Clinton Portis go.
I see
idea. But Mark Ingram was just as productive as Kamara was. It might be one of those lines where you can plug anybody back there and they're going to do phenomenal. Maybe you get what you can for Kamara. You can get a first rounder for Kamara easy. You take that and then you roll with a guy like maybe Fournette.
And that's true.
He could have a monster year, and you just pick up a guy that you're not going to lose any production possibly and end up with a high draft pick out of it.
You've got to do what you can to keep Breeze protected, so you wouldn't think they'd want to do away with their running game. But, yeah, maybe they can plug somebody in, and maybe they can trade him for some better line to help protect him.
And he's going to get paid. He's on the verge of this contract, his rookie deal expiring, and he's going to want to get fucking paid, and he's going to get paid.
And he'll be
maybe
expensive.
They're trying to keep him safe because there is a hurricane going on down there.
That's true.
You think it is? All they care about is his safety.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like you know what? Some football fans would be like, I don't care if it fucking hits my house as long as Alvin's all right.
You leave Kamara alone.
Yeah.
Take me. Just don't hurt the running back.
Where do you think he goes? Who do you think? Where do you think Kamara would fit?
Anywhere. He'd fit anywhere.
Where would a good fit be? Sorry.
Kansas City?
Yeah, their starting running back is opting out this year.
Opting out this year.
Their rookie running back is?
No. Williams.
Oh. Yeah. Well, the rookie's probably going to be the starter anyway.
He will.
You think?
Oh, yeah.
But he's awfully undersized.
Yeah.
But I guess... Yeah, Williams wasn't huge. He was like 190 pounds or some shit.
Mm-hmm.
But this guy they got that they drafted is like 5'7". I mean, he's not real big.
They said the same thing about Felix Jones, and we saw how that turned out.
Yeah. Maurice Jones-Drew, dude.
How'd that turn out? Yeah, Maurice Jones-Drew was 5'7 and 340 pounds. He was actually built like a bowling ball.
He was.
He actually rolled. He actually didn't get that many yards because his knee was down constantly because they couldn't figure out where it was.
Nice. I would say if I were, I hope he goes to Chicago.
New England would be a spot.
That would be another spot. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're talking about Kamara.
No, Derek. Maurice Jones-Drew. Jesus Christ.
Well, no, I wasn't sure if we were talking about Kamara or the guy we were just talking about before.
Wait a minute. Fournette. Are you saying Chicago's interested in Mojo?
Yes. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
He's been retired a couple of years now, hasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he's on NFL.com.
Okay,
Their little show that they do. I still love the guy.
I like anybody that goes by initials.
Are the Bears looking at him to play quarterback?
Yes.
Yeah, you know, I'd take anybody to play quarterback right now.
You're going to be fine. You've got Foles. Shut up.
No.
Yes.
It's going to be bad.
Go, Foles.
I'm debating on renewing Sunday Ticket. That's how bad it's going to be.
Poor you.
Oh, it sucks.
Yeah. Here's my favorite football news of the week. Carson Wentz is apparently considered to be week to week. He has a minor lower body soft tissue injury.
That's a weird. I wonder if he tore a nut. That's what that's a lower body soft tissue.
This dude needs to be put into a fucking bubble. You know those bubbles you play soccer in now? That's what he needs to be put into.
When they say lower body, do they mean like lower leg. Abdomen or below leg. The waist?
Below the waist.
Okay, so a bad bruise, basically, is what
it sounds like, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't care.
Got a cock bruise.
Yeah, that's probably what it is.
Probably. You know, he throws his passes with that.
Mm-hmm. He needs to get all...
He's got
to
stop doing those cock push-ups.
Mm-hmm. He drives me fucking crazy.
It's my favorite depth chart, though.
Yeah, it's true.
Wentz hurts. Mm-hmm. That's 1-2.
Yeah. And in, okay, let's make a bet. Does what? Wentz...
You're on.
Does Wentz make it through the entire season?
Probably not.
No?
It doesn't sound like he's going to make it. I don't think he's going to make it to the opener,
yeah. That's my favorite part of Dumb and Dumber. I don't bet. Oh, I'll bet you $100 I can get you gambling by the end of the day. Oh, you're on. You're on. I'm going to get you. No, you're not. I love that.
Was that in the first one?
That's the first one.
Was that in the first one? Okay. Yeah.
They're in the shagging wagon.
That's so fucking great.
Driving. Okay, last thing, fantasy football, getting ready to start up. Our draft is coming up. Hope all of you guys that are listening and watching, I hope you guys have a fantasy football draft still this year. I was kind of talked into it, but...
I've been doing it for 10 years. I was kind of talked into it.
God, this one's going to be tough because you're not only drafting people that you're kind of scared to draft because they have a harsh like history with getting injured. Like drafting Carson Wentz a year ago.
My first round pick.
Would be stupid because he has such a history of getting injured. But now there's a wild card in this, which is the fucking virus. So it doesn't matter who you pick. Some star player that's not technically injured gets tested positive for corona and you're fucked.
They got to sit out mandatory 2 weeks? Is that what it is?
I think if you test positive, it's probably a week.
I thought it was two, but what if they test positive for AIDS?
Then you have to retire, and then it'll eventually cure itself.
Okay.
And then you buy the Dodgers.
Yeah.
That's what happens.
Fair enough.
That's what you're supposed to do, I think.
That's the way it works.
That was just HIV, guys.
Question.
Never went to full-blown AIDS.
Question about fantasy football. Who would be, if we all had the number one pick in the draft, who would it be?
Carson Wentz.
Mojo.
Serious.
Maurice Jones-Drew.
We have a buddy named...
New Bears quarterback, Maurice Jones-Drew.
Linebacker, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. We have a buddy that drafts with us. His name's Maddie, and every single year he always picks somebody that's been retired for 2 years.
Or hurt.
Goes up to the board 3 times. I am going to take Christian McCaffrey.
You take CMC.
I will take CMC. Number one. We should have won last year because of him, and last couple of weeks he didn't do so well for me. But
I would take Saquon.
I think that's a good pick too. I think he's going to have he's going to have a bounce back year, or it's going to be shit again. It's one of the two.
It's going to be the bathroom stall at your workplace.
I'd probably go Cook.
Dalvin Cook. That's tough because he's hurt all the time.
He wasn't hurt a single time. He was out one week, I think.
And he never played a full season.
Yeah, that's true.
This is the year you want to handcuff, though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because, I mean, with everything going on now,
yep,
that's the best time to have the second string running back on your team.
But I have a different strategy than a lot of people do. You know, I think in the first round, if...
Kicker all the way.
Absolutely.
You take a kicker.
If Mahomes or Lamar Jackson is available... Those are legitimate first-round picks, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Even though they're not running backs. Mm-hmm. I think that they are, because they are just about guaranteed to score you at least 20 points a week.
Yeah.
I think that they jump up in that.
Unless you have COVID.
And there's Mitch Trubisky.
Yeah, he'd be a good one.
Yeah, I think if he's available in the 16th round, you leave
him. I'm going to take him second round. I'm going to go Wentz 1 and then Trubisky.
And then
Mojo.
What are some of your favorite fantasy football names? Well, first of all, our fantasy football names. Derek's changes every year because he's, you know, Derek.
Yeah.
Mine's been Scooters Hooters for years.
Mm-hmm. Scotty likes boobs.
And I'm always the screaming queefs.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. I've been all sorts of different names. I've been the Skunts.
The Skunts.
Yeah, that's a skanky cunt.
Yep.
That was the Skunts 1 year. Trash Bisky last year.
Yeah, you were Trash Bisky last year. I like the Cunt Punters.
That was never that one.
I like that one.
Oh, you like that
one. I like that one. I would change my name to that one.
I like you the ones
get
that...
get a fucking jersey and everything.
I would get a jersey for it. Yeah, I would.
I like the Kobe ones...
Never gets old.
Never.
I like the ones that play off the player names.
Those are fun. They're kind of fun, but they're only good for a year.
No, I mean, if you've got the player. Like some of the best ones I've seen.
I like it when they don't get the player, still call their team that.
Like Zach Ertz.
Yeah.
They would have my ball, Zach Ertz.
Yeah.
And that's good. Cooper Kupp.
Yeah, Cooper Kupp.
Two girls, one cup.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty good.
I like the Bears, but B-A-R-E-S.
That's what I like to think is, what if, like, whenever they wrote the Second Amendment, mm-hmm. and they were like, we want the right to bear arms, they're like, you don't think they're going to be thinking about weapons or anything. No, they got to know we just like wearing tank tops. It's hot out here in Philadelphia. And I just like to picture just a bunch of guys with powdered wings and tank tops, like sun's out, guns out. I just think that is a wonderful image to me.
I like to think that everybody has arms like a large
bear.
Gay man.
Yeah. Very well done. All right.
Goddamn right it was, Scotty.
Anybody else have any other sports they want to go over? That's my short list of the
soccer. We got soccer. What do we got for soccer?
Who gives a fuck?
Hurling.
All right.
Hurling.
Hurling?
Yeah.
Not curling?
No, nope. Hurling. It's an Irish sport.
What? Oh. I should know about
this. Which one is that?
It's kind of like baseball, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, there's that one.
Fair enough. Mm-hmm.
I just want to go over it.
Let's
did that.
Let's do a sweep of the out-of-town scoreboard in hurling.
I'm curious on how the horseshoe tournament's going.
Okay.
Yeah. But anyways,
you guys ever any good at horseshoes?
Yeah, I was pretty decent.
Were you? Mm-hmm. I never.
The thing
I
is,
I know
though,
some guys who are real good at.
Well,
it.
It's like the Depression era of cornhole. That's what it is.
You're not supposed to throw them overhand. I found that out late in life. Uh-huh. So I was really good,
especially when your brother's down there.
Yeah, my guy, the guy I was playing against, wouldn't even get a throw. I'd knock him right the fuck out after that first one.
You won every fucking round by TKO.
Yeah,
that's great.
Scotty, it wasn't like Depression era. It was cornhole before cornhole is what it was.
Well, I mean, it's the same idea is all I'm saying.
Right. It's just a lot easier to play in football stadium parking lots because
right.
you can't pound stakes into the asphalt. They don't care for that.
Yeah.
Get out the sled. Get out the jackhammer. We're going to make a hole right here because yep. you always take your shit with you. Or I like to leave the stakes in the ground in the parking lot and just let people hit them.
Yeah.
Tear off their fucking radiators and shit.
Nice. Okay, moving on. We get to questions and comments. Listener questions and comments and just other questions that we have.
Okay.
First one up, Tyler Turner last week wanted to comment on our midget sports.
What's his name?
Tyler Turner.
Fuck you, Tyler!
He wanted a shout-out.
Yeah, I did want a shout-out.
Did he? Oh, okay.
There it was.
There it was.
I don't know. I was just going off that TikTok thing.
Yeah.
What is your name?
Oh, yeah. That's one of my favorites.
Tony. Fuck you, Tony. What's your name?
Ezekiel.
Fuck you, Ezekiel.
I don't know that one yet.
Oh, it's great.
They have it with dogs.
Yeah,
they do. See each other at a distance a lot.
Yeah. he wanted to put in there the midget MMA.
That would be MMMA.
Triple
midget,
MA.
Midget mixed martial art.
That's good.
Ma.
the triple MA.
Yeah.
Let's see. We had another little thing from last week. Derek said that.
What'd I say?
It was referring to the Special Olympics on how they were mingling.
Fucking? You mean fucking, Scotty?
Well, trying to fuck.
Talking about tard sex?
Yes.
Okay.
Follower, because
that is a big thing. Is
the only kind of porno I watch.
It's really become an issue in this day and age. The Down syndrome rape culture gone on. It really needs to be consensual.
Do you think? Do you think when retarded people are orgasm, they just make a normal face? You think that happens? Just I'm coming. I'm coming.
Oh shit, they won't allow that one, I guarantee
you. I'm going to hell.
yeah, save me
a seat. Can I have a chance to answer?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yes, I do. And Jesus. I've got at least 4 websites brought up on my phone to prove it.
All digital boobs.
Anyways,
Helmets and Hooters.
Follower Young Craxon said that it would probably sound like a bicycle accident. I thought that was pretty clever. Let's see. What's the next one? Narmstro 007. What's the funniest way you have ever been injured? I actually have one.
Okay. Well, let's hear it.
I actually do.
It was not funny at the time, but thinking back on it, it kind of was.
Well, you guys are the funny ones. I'll tell mine.
Any way you get hurt is funny, Scotty.
That's totally true.
Yeah, we're huge fans.
I was a freshman in high school, and I played baseball all the way up until college. I I that was the first time I ever had to wear a cup was whenever I played baseball in high school. Beginning of the season, the cup before every single game, he would check and make sure all of us wore a cup. Well, I played center field, and I had a beat on a ball, line drive into the gap, and I had a great jump on it, and I had to lay out. But what you don't think about is when you lay out for a catch, you land flat on your stomach, and that pushed the cup up and fucking pinched both of my nuts.
Mm.
And I didn't have to walk off the field or get escorted off the field, but it took me every bit of 5 to 10 minutes of recovery. That's probably one of the funniest things. And then I never wore a cup again, ever.
I wish it would have taken your nuts off.
Well, I don't have
anything that can castrate keep you from breeding.
I don't have kids, Jeremy. We're good.
Yet. There's always that chance.
Jesus, I hope not.
Yeah, if somebody leaves it in him, he could get pregnant.
Fuck you,
nobody
Derek.
Wants that.
All right.
And Ezekiel.
Right.
He'd probably
That's
name
a
it.
Jewish name.
He'd probably name it.
It is.
Probably name it Leonard.
Leonard
McFuckstick.
I was going to name it Derek, but you're such a prick.
Anyways. Yes.
Yeah, go ahead, Jeremy.
When I was, I want to say like fifth, sixth grade, my friend Jason, who lived across the street from me, had a basketball goal set up inside of his garage.
Oh, shit.
It like hooked over the top of the garage door.
Yeah.
So the door had to be shut.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it wasn't a 10-foot goal. It was like 7.
Mm-hmm.
So, and he was a year older than me and hit like this growth spurt. And so he could dunk and I almost could with those little mini basketballs, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I kept trying. And at one point I just gave it hell. And some point I got turned around in the air and, you know, the garage door handle that sticks up on the inside.
Yeah.
I got turned around and basically sat down on that as I came down and it literally tore me a new asshole. It got like right up under the cheek. It. I think 15 stitches.
Oh, my God.
It was deep. The doctor, once she got me all numbed up and shit, I mean, she got it into the first knuckle. It was just a one knuckler.
Oh, God.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, that was no good.
Oh.
No fun.
Oh, man, that's tough to beat. Derek?
You guys know I used to race back in the day, and I was racing the Sprint Cup series, and Tony Stewart ran me off the road.
Oh, yeah?
And so,
yeah.
So I got a little mad. I had
to piss you off.
I got out of my car. I was pissed. I walked up the track right at him. He fucking hit me and killed me.
What a dick.
What a prick, Derek. Nah.
What'd you do?
I died.
Yeah, right there, huh?
Uh-huh, on the scene.
Huh. Oh, Lord.
No, actually.
Boy, I hope. Well, my condolences.
Yeah, that was a callback.
I hope everything works out okay.
I'll bring you flowers.
That was a callback to that Kevin Ware thing. Or not Kevin Ware, Kevin Ward Jr.
Yeah.
One time I went golfing, and we were in the golf cart, and we're fucking flying around the course, right? And there's a divot.
Okay. A divot?
Yeah, like a big divot from where.
Yeah,
so we go around that. Okay. And then there's like these trees.
Uh-huh.
So we went around those. And then we got right up to the flag of the hole where the hole was at.
Yeah.
And I got out and I made a putt. And then I pistol whipped a guy. And I broke my finger pistol whipping him.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. Hate when that happens. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got to have.
You got to carry on the course.
Uh-huh. Well, and you got to be careful with your grip. You got to have the right grip. You got to hold it sideways.
Yep.
Uh-huh.
You got to keep the wrist not too stiff, but kind of stiff. You don't want to go all
limp.
Know, yeah, limp
you don't want to go limp wristed.
Yeah.
Right.
No, believe it or not, I'm as graceful as a gazelle. And I have never really had anything that's been funnily injured. I know that sounds stupid, but and unbelievable, but I've never actually. If I've hurt myself, it's just because I broke a glass and...
Okay, well, change that to comedically injured, because that sounds like you got hurt by a funnel.
I like that better.
Okay.
Funnily injured?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you this.
It was funnel cake.
I've eaten funnel cake until I hurt myself.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't wait for it to finish cooking. I went right in after it.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Face first.
Uh-huh. Guy your size, I'm surprised you hadn't ate too much or something like that. Your stomach started hurting. That counts.
Fuck you, Scotty.
Yes.
That was really a nasty that thing to say, Scotty. That was a horrible thing.
And I don't give
why
a
would
shit.
You, why would you hurt his feelings you like that?
You don't make fun of people, Scotty.
Still don't give a fuck. Like, I'm over here still not giving a fuck.
It's not about it's not about you.
Boy, I don't like the turn that this podcast is taking.
I know. Either. Then it's went suck. Real dark.
Let's get it back to comedy. Is what's the funniest way you've ever hurt somebody?
Yeah.
Because I got one of those, too.
Well, let's hear it.
Let's hear it. What do you got?
I was playing baseball. I want to say senior Babe Ruth. I would have been 16 or 17 at the time. And I was playing left field. Or no, I was playing center field, but I was shifted towards left field.
You were the and rover.
Yeah, kind of, except there wasn't a guy in the center. But guy was on second base, and the batter hit a pretty good line drive for a base hit, and the second baseman was going to score from second. And I didn't have the best arm, but I had a pretty accurate arm, and I wasn't too deep in the outfield, and I fired it in to the catcher and hit him in the front leg as he was crossing home plate, which knocked his leg over in front of the trailing leg, and he tripped over his own leg and just face planted and skinned his fucking face all up.
Oh shit.
He still scored, but it was like, fuck you. Fuck you for scoring that run, you dick.
Baseball players have the best stories. I'm not going to go into an injury one, but don't you
love a great story. One time there were three Bears.
Don't you love it when somebody like rounds three
gay guys?
Third base? Yeah.
What? Three big burly gay guys?
Yes, that's what the whole fucking story's about, Derek. Who pay love attention. Porridge.
Yes.
God.
At different temperatures.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways.
Fuck,
Derek. Anyways.
And then there were people sleeping in their bed.
I don't like this turn with you getting upset with us. That's not what you do here. You take it.
You just bend over that fucking pegboard and you take it.
Okay, whatever.
We are not the victims here.
Don't you love it when somebody's rounding third base and you can kind of see them start to trip and keep going, but you can see that in about maybe 20 feet, they are eventually going to not make it to home plate and they'll fall on their face?
They don't have to be rounding third for me to love that. I love it any time that happens.
Shit you not.
There is something... I will eventually be like, oh, shit, I hope he's okay. But anytime somebody falls, my immediate reaction is to laugh.
The only reason why I said that is because it happened to us my senior year right before college baseball. This is during the summer, so this is right before college baseball starts. We had a player on our team that did that. Hit third base, and you can see it coming from a mile away. He's going to fall flat on his face here in a second. Shit you not, the catcher himself, which is a big burly guy, ran out of the dugout right about where the coach's box is, did a somersault, flat on his stomach, laid prone, acted with a baseball bat, acted like it was a sniper rifle, and waited for him to get ready to hit the ground and went, snipe, motherfucker!
Wow.
It's the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Yeah.
All right, we got to
move. Yeah. There's something about people falling, though. When people genuinely fall, not like an on-purpose acting pratfall, there's never anything graceful about it because it always catches the person off guard.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
They're never, like, especially like if somebody thinks that if there's like going down a flight of stairs and they think there's one more stair, but there's not. Or,
oh, that's a good one, too.
They think that they're at the bottom, but there's still one more
stair.
Oh, yeah. That I love it.
Good stuff.
I don't care if they, break their legs.
Yep.
I'll take them to the hospital, but I'm going to get a good chuckle out of that.
Oh, shit. We got a couple more questions. We got to move
on. Oh, do we?
Here we go. Schley from TikTok wants to know, by the way, we are from Kansas. She wants to know if we have...
I'm married. No, I will not fuck you. No, you can't have an orgasm.
Schley wants to know if we actually have tornadoes as bad as everybody says they are. Like if we have as many tornadoes and as deadly tornadoes as people.
Yeah, think. Twister was a documentary, in case you didn't know.
No, it's not. Oh, God, come on. It's like one of the worst movies of all time.
They just pop up out of nowhere. That's what happens. I mean, it's sunny day. Boom, tornado, gone. It's like a drive-by shooting in Chicago. That's what it is.
We were in the house one time in my bedroom, and this tornado comes. It sucks the whole fucking house up. Next thing I know, we land on a witch, and everything's in color. That's how they fucking work.
God, and that's the other thing, being from Kansas, the fucking Wizard of Oz references, like that's our one claim to fame.
I love that, the whole thing about people looking at us, the Land of Oz. No, if you recall right, when she got to the Land of Oz, she says, we're not in Kansas anymore. It's the opposite of whatever the fuck Kansas is. Kansas is just gray and brown everywhere. That place was beautiful, and it's not here.
That's yeah.
She was trying to get the fuck out of there and back here for some reason.
Yeah, I don't know why.
But no, they're not.
We get, I mean, what, like 3 weeks warning if it's going to be a big one?
At least
a week.
Well, we know when the storms are going to happen that can generate tornadoes. And, you know, we usually get some heads-up notice.
Mm-hmm.
And in the big scheme of things, Kansas is a very spacious place. And tornadoes, even the biggest tornadoes, are like a half mile wide. I mean, they can only take out so much of a swath. So when they do happen, the areas they hit are devastated, but it's not terribly.
And they target trailer parks. They very rarely go into the
Jesus
city.
Jesus Christ. Backpacking city.
What is true? They do. They don't. You never see a tornado in the city, actually. They're always in the outskirts.
Do you not recall the one that tore up Moore, Oklahoma?
Rest my case.
Yeah, there are a lot of trailer parks.
So,
but it got the Warren Theater down there.
Yeah, it sure did.
Yeah.
Let's see.
That's where Toby Keith is from.
Let's see. I've got, I got one more. If you had to wear a mask for the rest of your life, what kind of mask would you pick?
Ski mask.
Why?
Because shopping would be an adventure every day. That would be the greatest thing in the world.
And banking?
Banking would be phenomenal. So, yeah, I'd fucking wear a ski mask all fucking day. It's 105. Why do you got a ski mask on?
And how many times a week does somebody come up to you, hey, want to go skiing? Can't. Forgot my fucking mask.
Yeah.
Not a problem anymore.
Nope.
Yeah, okay. All right. I'm going to go with a ninja mask, man. Like the full getup.
The balaclava?
More like Sub-Zero from Mortal Kombat.
That's not a ninja mask.
What the fuck else do you call it?
A mask? It's not a ninja mask. A fucking ninja mask.
It still is a fucking mask.
He's not a ninja, though.
I thought he was. He's blue.
Ninjas aren't blue, Scott.
Yeah, Scotty.
What are you playing? Ninja Gaiden? Get out of here with that fucking bullshit ninja shit.
I hate to...
Ninja, please. I mean, come on.
I hate to sound racist, but they're yellow usually.
No, that's Scorpion. I'd wear a Scorpion.
Not his outfit.
Oh.
The ninja.
Oh.
Himself. When he takes... That mask comes off.
He's a ninja. Right there.
I'd wear Anna Kournikova's panties.
Anna Kournikova's panties now or 1995?
Definitely 95. only because I don't know what she looks like now.
She's still hot, I will tell you that.
Well, then just
very married.
Any old Kournikova panties.
Very well done.
Do I have to wear them while I'm sleeping? Because I'm gonna.
All right, those are our questions and comments for this week.
Hopefully she hasn't had a day like the old man at Scotty's work. Because we all have those days, no matter how hot you are.
Especially if it's that time of month, then it's going to look like Neapolitan ice cream.
Oh, God. No.
Mm-hmm.
No. No.
It'll be Neapolitan.
Scotty.
Yeah.
Because she only wore the white.
Uh-huh, red, white.
Welcome all the female followers. We really appreciate you.
And goodbye.
Yep.
Anyways, that was our comments and questions from the listeners. Guys, if you have a question, comment, anything that you want us to say on the show, comment anywhere, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok. We see all of them.
We're going to ask you a favor, actually.
Okay.
We want to see how many people you can get Scotty. Tell Scotty he sucks. How many people can we get to do that? So I want to see as many Facebook and TikTok comments Scotty what a piece of shit he is.
And for those who just follow us on TikTok, that's Scotty.
That's him right there. Yeah, we just want to know how big of a piece of shit you think Scotty is. Tell us all. Comment.
I can't leave. They're too fucking fat. I can't get around.
That's by design.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got this fat just
to box
to
you
keep
in.
You from getting out.
Pieces of shit.
When you asked me to do this podcast, I weighed 114 pounds.
Okay. All right. So now, So, yeah, comment. We'll get them. We'll put them on our show if we like them. So,
okay. Just don't be talking multiple orgasm bullshit, women.
I don't know. She wins. She got it on the show. But didn't give her a shout out.
Yeah, because that's real tough. Only because I don't remember her name.
Yeah.
She was nice enough to comment.
Yeah.
But she's dead fucking wrong.
All right. Now we get to move on.
To what?
The draft, baby.
Oh. All right.
The draft. And I wanted to give a special shout out because I forgot to give him a shout out last time. Our last week's draft was I wrote him the fuck down. Where the hell did he go? Nick, buddy, I'm going to try to pronounce your name. Nick Masciangelo. Masciangelo. I hope that's right.
Well, you're full of Italian words today.
I think like one of his names is like Italian baseball player. He's a good kid. I like a lot of his questions.
What's his first name, Nick?
Nick.
Fuck you, Nick.
But last week's draft was best teams that didn't win a championship.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for that, that, Nick. We really appreciate it.
Who won the draft?
Who won the draft?
I believe I did.
Pull it up.
Pull it up. Let's see. Pull it up. Come on, guys. Don't fucking fail me. Please don't fucking fail me.
Let's see.
It was a screamer.
It was very close.
It was very close.
Let's see.
Derek had it most of the way.
He did.
There we go.
But you're going back and forth.
There we go. Oops, that's a comment. The wow. Am I the wow? I got it. 29-27.
Fucking asshole.
How?
That's what it is.
Because of fucking Brian Choi. You reached out to assholes.
I did not.
Fuck Brian Choi and his delicious barbecue.
That's right.
Son of a bitch.
You voted with two different profiles.
They don't know that.
I even voted for Jeremy.
Yeah, you even made the page vote for Jeremy.
I even had the page vote for Jeremy because I was goddamn Derek.
Well, and because my picks were better.
That's true. They were better.
I don't know.
Shut up. All right. So Derek won last week's draft.
That's five in a row. Jesus,
is it
feel
five
like
or four? I think it's four.
I think it might be 13. No,
I think it's four.
That still puts me right where I like to be in the two hole.
Yep. So this week,
you know what? Though, big congrats to Scotty. He beat the likes.
I did. Well, I think we're kind of getting people to figure out how to vote now.
Yeah, you think so?
I think so. So, moving on to this week's draft. This week's draft is something I think is going to be kind of fun, kind of special. It's not going to be a sports draft. This is actually going to be a stand-up comedians draft.
Yep. Favorite ones that committed sexual assault.
Mm. Ooh, Bill Cosby,
Louis C.K.
Anyways, no, these
George
are
George Burns.
These are our.
I'm sure he did.
Our.
What if it turns out he just was awful?
These are our favorite stand-up comedians. So
I wanted to one launch my official protest on this. Oh. I'm going to do it.
Yeah,
I think it's a bad pick because, quite frankly, most of the comedians that me and Derek know.
Mm-hmm.
Are probably not your mainstream people that everybody knows, even though they're funnier.
Mm-hmm.
Most people don't know what funny is.
Yeah.
They know what's on Netflix. They know what's shown to them.
Yeah.
So this is just going to be a popularity contest.
Uh-huh.
Also, I would like to put a stipulation on it.
Okay.
That they have to be a current working comedian.
Oh.
No legends.
No.
Oh, that's tough.
Okay, I'm ready.
That knocks out about five of mine.
Current
Well,
working?
I mean, everybody knows Carlin and Pryor. And, I mean,
yeah, you motherfucker, I have the first pick.
Right. What I'm saying is that those guys are...
All right.
I mean, they're kind of above reproach, and they don't even really touch my top five.
You would just lose this draft is what's going to happen.
Well, yeah, I'm probably going to lose anyway, even though I'll probably have the best picks.
Okay.
Because, people are too stupid to know funny.
If you want to go that route, we can go that route.
I love how we make decisions about shit like this on the show whenever we've known 3 days before.
You just texted this today.
I texted it yesterday.
No.
Damn, and we warped speed 3 days.
All right.
It wasn't 3 days ago.
Fine. We'll do current. God, that's no. I don't want to do current. I want to do all time.
Okay, but people, what we're gonna do is get all kinds of fucking stupid people coming.
What about Cat Williams?
What about Bill Hicks? I like Bill Hicks because he was He never apologized for nothing. That's fine. He was never funny either.
But that's fine, though. I think that that's a good way of going it because that kind of shows our all times. And we can pick current ones. I'm going to pick a couple current ones.
I'm going to only pick current ones.
Okay, that's fine. You only pick current ones. I'm going to pick first pick of the week, and I'm going to take George Carlin, motherfucker. GC. Okay. Take away my George Carlin.
Shit, piss, fuck, cunt, cocksucker, motherfucker, tits. Hilarious.
Yeah, I love it. I liked him. He's probably my number one of all time, and I can watch him whenever I can. I mean, I love him. Favorite one.
I'm sure his material really relates that 70s fucking hippie shit.
All right. Well, Jeremy, you have number two.
Okay. Well, even though I'm sure I'm not a risk to lose this guy to anybody, he's still number one in my book. He was my inspiration for becoming a stand-up.
Okay.
Jimmy Pardo.
Yeah. But people know who he is.
Most people don't.
Well, now you listen to this show, now you can look up Jimmy Pardo. That's the whole idea.
Okay.
All right. Derek?
Sam Kinison.
Yeah.
He's my favorite comedian of all time.
I knew it was coming, but I kind of wanted you to have that one because you've loved him forever.
Yeah, ever since. That was the first comedian I ever watched, and I loved him.
Okay.
Dave Chappelle.
Damn it. You fuckhead. I liked that one, too. I thought I was going to get him late.
Nope. Dave Chappelle is a legend.
Yeah, he is. Excellent, excellent new special, if you haven't seen it, by the way.
Boy, who do I want to take with number two?
Amy Schumer.
I'm going to go Gary Goldman.
Gary Goldman's a good one.
He's a great one.
Yeah.
In my opinion, top two or three working today.
Yeah, okay. All right. I'm pumped. I'm pumped right here.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, I'm going to give you the one that you want.
Okay.
I think.
Okay.
Because I'm not going to take them because I want to have some current guys.
Okay.
But if I'm going to be true to myself, I am going to, without a shadow of a doubt, take Mitch Hedberg.
Fucker.
Oh, is that the one you wanted?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well then, cool. I'm happy. That he's probably the best one-liner of all time, in my opinion.
Okay.
My next one that I'm going to take, I'm going to take Brad Williams.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Midget, comedian, and he's fucking hysterical.
Yeah, I opened for him here.
Yeah, there you go.
Mm-hmm.
All right, back to you, Jeremy.
To me, John Mulaney.
That's a good one.
He was on my list.
See?
I know they're good.
Yeah.
they're better than what most people know.
Derek, you get two, man.
Bill Burr?
Fuck! Yep. You want to talk about somebody that can piss ladies off? Woo! He'd be the guy.
Let me erase Mulaney here. I had that one on there. I've got a few, and I know we're going to catch shit for not picking some of them.
Oh, I know for sure.
Oh, I'm down between two, and he's not going to make it back. I'm going to go with my favorite one-liner guy, Rodney Dangerfield.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I love Rodney Dangerfield.
I don't know. I know who you're talking about, and do I want to win, or do I want to be honest with myself? All right.
I know I'm going to catch shit.
Todd Glass does a character called Roger Dangerfield, who is Rodney's brother, who comes up with the premises, but he doesn't make them jokes. They're just complaints. You know, boy, I tell you, my wife, she sure can't cook. Every time she makes a meal, we don't enjoy it. Boy, my daughter, she ain't too smart either. She flunked out of her fourth college in the last 3 years. There's no joke with that. Just awful shit.
There's an interesting story. I don't know if I've told it on the show. I read his book. I don't read a lot of books. You'd never know that by
Rodney Dangerfield.
I read his book. I think it's a biography. And he actually was going to quit doing comedy.
Mm-hmm.
He was going to quit. He went he started doing siding and roofing jobs. And he went somewhere in some town and they started all these roofing jobs and he sold all these jobs. And he went to go collect the money, And the guy was like, why don't you just leave town and we'll just call it good? And he's like, well, no, you don't understand. I don't know what you're talking about here. I need to get paid for these jobs so I can pay my guys. No, just leave. You know, that's it. We're done here. And he's fucking sitting at the bar. He has no idea what to do. He's sitting there drinking a glass of scotch or whiskey or whatever, or beer, and he has no idea what to do in this situation. And he stopped doing comedy by this point, and I think there was an open mic or something, and he went up and he told some jokes, and he went and he sat back at the bar, and there was a guy sitting at the bar and come up to him and was like, man, that was really funny. I really enjoyed that. And they got to chatting, and he kind of told him his situation. The guy goes, I'll have your money tomorrow. And he wow. goes, what? And he goes, I'll get your money tomorrow. Well, I guess that guy was like one of the big banker guys in town and told the guy that was refusing to pay. He goes, hey, this guy's connected with the mafia. We just need to get him the fuck out of here. Like, we need to pay him and have him go. And the guy fucking paid him the next day.
Wow.
Yeah. And that's crazy. After that, he's like, well, maybe I should give comedy one last shot.
He was known, incredibly hardworking.
Oh, yeah.
You would never think it by looking at, and was also well known for having a huge schvant. And he had his club in New York called Rodney's and would often walk around with an open bathrobe. but yeah, if you know him from his movies, Easy Money or Back to School,
Caddyshack,
don't go by that shit. Go back and actually listen to his old stand-up stuff. It's for the time fucking brilliant.
All right,
mine again.
Yep, you get two more, but you get one.
Was that Todd Glass or does that?
No,
what you,
okay, no. I like Todd Glass very much. Great. Podcaster, but I wouldn't put him in my top five stand-ups. I'm going to go Rory Scovel.
Okay. Rory Scovel. Don't. I think I may. I don't know. I may know who that is.
You probably don't, but anyway.
Maybe.
Okay, have you ever seen that movie, The House?
Mm-hmm.
Where he's the guy who's the shirtless ring girl during the fight?
Mm-hmm.
That's Rory Scovel.
Oh.
But he's also a brilliant stand-up.
Okay.
So, fuck you, Scotty.
Sorry. Okay, I've got a lot that I can choose from, but I do want to pick. I have to do it, but I've got my last two. The first one is Richard Pryor.
Yeah, that was where I was torn on between Dangerfield and Pryor.
Yeah, and I think I would definitely go Pryor all day long. I actually was going to pick that after Mitch Hedberg, but I decided to not because I figured you wanted him. But I can't do my list any justice if I did not pick my favorite current stand-up comedian right now. But I knew he would probably under the radar because if you look stand-up comedians up on Google or anything like that, he's pretty much not going to be there because he's not necessarily known for it.
Scotty, I am very honored
and
to be your last pick. I think I should have been a little bit higher.
Derek can suck a dick. I'm picking Joe fucking Rogan. He is one of my favorite stand-up comedians of all time, and he makes me laugh every single special.
You can have him.
I think he's a great comedian, and he sticks up for comedians that do not – or that get their shit stolen, that are joke thieves. And I really like the fact that he went up on stage and made fun of Carlos Mencia and called him out for it.
I worked with him too.
Mencia?
Yep, I did.
He's probably stole a joke from you.
Nah, well, I haven't heard much from him. Maybe he did.
That's why he's not working anymore. Okay, let's close this out. Jeremy?
Oh, God damn it.
Biscuits and mustard.
I was going to say, it sounds like Shredder off of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
I've already gone with the one guy that nobody probably knows who they are, so I'll go with the more mainstream guy. I'm going to go Pete Holmes.
Okay.
That's a good one.
That's a good one. I like it.
I think Dana Gould is actually a much better stand-up, but most people only know him as he was a writer on The Simpsons for a long time.
Hmm. All right. Derek.
God, I have so many.
Close us out, dude. I got a whole bunch.
I've got Bill Hicks on here, even though Jeremy just ripped on him. I liked him.
Yep.
Don Rickles is on here.
That's one I would have known Jeremy would have picked.
Chris Rock.
Yep.
Jeff Ross, I like a lot. Red Fox. Mm-hmm. Stanhope is fucking great. I'm surprised you didn't pick Stanhope. I'm going to go with, and he's not alive anymore, but I think the guy was fucking brilliant, Greg Giraldo.
Mm, good one.
I love Greg Giraldo. And if you ever watch any of the roasts, he always had the fucking hardest hitting jokes. I remember there's one joke he talks about where he said something about he saw three crackheads in a subway and they were singing a cappella. And he's like, all I could think of is how the fuck did these guys meet? Were they just sitting there like, man, I need some crack. Me two, me three.
You think he would have been able to get away with this shit today?
No.
He probably died.
But he wouldn't give a fuck. He'd do it anyway.
Most people say, you know, we lost him too soon. Him, lost him about the right time, I think.
That's so horrible.
What's fucked up about him is he had a Harvard law degree.
Yeah.
He was a lawyer.
You know how him and Jeff Ross met?
I'm going to guess doing comedy. What, he defend?
Yeah, Jeff he defended Jeff something? Ross. Yeah. Jeff Ross did a show like at a college, and they got Jeff Ross. He incited a riot. And I guess they went to court over it, or Jeff Ross, he'd met Jeff Ross at the bar or something, and he was telling him about it. He's like, let me represent you. He's like, he went to Harvard Law, Greg Giraldo did. Mm-hmm. And fucking went and just ran circles around this public defender. And him and Jeff Ross became friends, and fucking he quit being an attorney quit law school and went and did comedy. And fucking was amazing.
I guess it's kind of one of those things where it sounds like a really daring thing to do, but that law degree ain't going anywhere. You can always go back.
Yeah. Especially
when it's from Harvard.
Yeah.
So maybe it wasn't all that brave. Plus, he probably had some extra cash.
Yeah.
Saved up. So maybe he's not that great. What I'm trying to say here is fuck Greg Giraldo.
Quite a few, actually.
The one we're going to get fucking crucified for is Robin Williams.
He was on my list.
I don't like him.
As a stand-up. Well, okay, liked him as a dramatic actor.
As a dramatic actor.
Absolutely. As an actor,
fine. But a lot of people don't know why. A lot of people don't really know the stories about Robin Williams. I do because I hang out with you guys and I hear all these stories, and it was a heartbreaker to me. I mean, he was literally one of my favorite actors of all time was Robin Williams. But when you find out behind the scenes, he was actually a joke thief. And then Derek would tell me his story. Well, you tell the story better. He would actually
Go to the Laugh Factory in L.A. and there was a red light in the back of the room. And as soon as Robin Williams walked in, somebody would flip that light on and off like a fucking air raid siren, and somebody might be mid-joke on stage and just drop the mic and walk off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But there's also on the other side of that story, too, if you ever confronted him about it, I believe, like one guy I know, a comic, had said that he confronted him about it, like, hey, I saw you do one of my jokes on The Tonight Show. Oh, which joke was that? Oh, okay. And he'd just whip out a checkbook and write him a check.
Yeah, but it was usually like for $100, going rate for a joke. And my whole thing is, if you're a budding comedian trying to get started,
every joke matters.
Yes, every joke matters. If that, when I opened for Donnie Baker, there was a guy there who was doing a live stream of his podcast who, my set went out on YouTube and he kept it posted for a little while. And it's like, dude, that's my only 15 minutes that I just did there. You can't keep that up or else you're going to burn it. Uh-huh. I mean,
yeah. Oh, yeah. They're going to be like, I just saw this show on YouTube.
Right.
Yeah.
Wasn't the video of me, just the audio, but it was all my shit. And it's like, it takes a long time for a new comedian to craft and polish.
Yeah, sure.
A 15 minute set. Yeah. And so, yeah, if you're trying to get started and that's your way in, now it's burned because everybody's going to think you're stealing Robin Williams' shit.
Yeah. But for what it's worth, bringing this place back up, who were some other comedians you had? I had a couple of ones that weren't on a whole bunch of lists. I had Dennis Leary was one that I really liked.
Mm-hmm. He stole from Bill Hicks.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. God damn it. He certainly stole his style.
All right,
fine. But, I mean, it was, you know, that whole I got two words for you shit got old.
And you're gonna just ruin all the other ones I like. Kevin James.
Okay.
Is that okay?
No. But
yeah, I mean, if that's your guy.
I like him.
Yeah.
Eddie
not really known as a
Eddie
Murphy as much.
Eddie Murphy didn't write. Paul Mooney wrote the majority of Eddie Murphy's.
God damn it, you're fucking ruining everybody.
He wrote the majority of Eddie Murphy.
Okay, he's very homophobic, too.
Tom Segura.
Love him. Like Tom Segura.
Okay, I'm going to end on that one.
Tom Segura is a brilliant stand-up.
Yes, I knew you were going to put Tom and Bert on your list. I'm surprised you didn't pick either one of them.
I got really close to picking Tom, Bert, but that's like a triad of friends that I really just enjoy. I love Tom, I love Bert, but I love Joe Rogan.
A couple guys that people haven't heard of that they should look into, he's starting to get bigger now, is Chad Daniels.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck yeah. Chad Daniels is hilarious.
Fucking amazing.
You talk about unapologetic and some hardcore shit.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
he doesn't care about being PC.
I got another one that people probably haven't heard of that need to look up, and that's Andrew Schultz.
Okay,
I don't know that one. Look him up. He's from New York. He's now up and coming. He kind of has his own deal going right now, and he's getting kind of popular. He's going to be the next big one, I bet.
I like dark humor. Jeselnik would have been up there.
Jeselnik's another good one.
I fucking love Anthony Jeselnik.
And then your friend,
Mike
Matt Donaher.
No, Matt Donaher.
Oh, okay.
Certainly an up-and-comer.
Yeah.
Yeah, Matt Donaher's very funny.
You had brought up Red Fox.
Yes.
The story about him at the Excalibur in Vegas on Christmas Day.
The one did I tell you that story? Have you heard that from somebody
I've heard else? That's a legendary story.
It's fucking phenomenal.
He racked up a big-ass gambling debt
mm-hmm.
at the Excalibur, and he probably had the money to pay it off, but didn't want to. And so they said, well, if you do the show on Christmas afternoon, we'll just wipe out the debt. And so he said okay, and there was like 12 people mm-hmm. at this show and there was like a band that played the Sanford and Son theme song, and he comes out in the band and he goes up to the mic, fuck this, I'm not performing for 12 people, and walks off, and the band
without missing a beat, yeah.
and that was literally, he walked off the stage. It wasn't a bit. He did.
Todd Yon.
And paid his fucking, paid his debt, I guess.
Todd Yon told me that story, which is another comment. He doesn't do comedy anymore, but he was fucking hilarious. Uh-uh.
Really?
No, he just plays in his band. I believe it was the Time Pilots. I don't know what it is now.
He's a good guitarist.
He's phenomenal. And another guy, he just moved to Wichita, but he took third in the San Francisco comedy competition, and I think he's fucking hysterical, is Mike Baldwin.
Mm-hmm. You told me about him.
I think he is hilarious.
Yeah. All right, we got to move on before Jim.
Okay.
All right.
Fine.
Let's move on to.
I don't have others.
You don't have any others? Oh no, you didn't get to tell you. I'm sorry. Here you go.
I don't give a shit.
Okay.
It's mostly gonna be people that they've never heard of.
Yeah, that's fine.
Sam Talent.
Nope.
Did you go see him?
No.
He was fucking great. That was the hardest I've ever laughed in the loony bin, I think.
Really?
Was watching that guy about a year ago, probably.
Greg Warren, I would have put him up there.
Greg Warren.
And he kept me in stand up.
Good for that guy.
Yeah,
good job.
I don't like him already.
Yep, me neither. Okay, so now we get to move on to my favorite part of every single episode. This is what we like to call the Laughing on the Sideline Shitty Situation of the Week. Okay, guys, this week's Laughing on the Sidelines Shitty Situation of the Week. It's inspired by a suggestion. Dawson Near.
Fuck you, Dawson.
More like Dawson Far, huh?
Dawson, you had a good suggestion, but we're going to break it down. We're going to actually have...
What was the suggestion?
So the suggestion was, would you rather jump off of a train moving 55 miles an hour or bitch slap your mother with no explanation or follow-up?
That's the dumbest thing I've ever fucking... What? Would you rather commit suicide or slap your mom?
One of them will make Thanksgiving dinner awkward. The other will assuredly kill you.
Yeah.
55 is fast.
So, yeah, it's very fast. So, yeah. We're gonna alter that just a little bit, and Derek's gonna tell us what we're doing.
Okay.
All right.
So Scotty's weird and likes weddings, but nobody else really likes to go to a fucking wedding.
I love weddings.
The dinner, getting fucked up and eating food afterwards, that's great. But the wedding part sucks.
Anybody who has a cash bar at their wedding can go fuck themselves.
Right. You really don't wanna fucking be there. We're all just sitting there. It's an outdoor wedding. It's fucking hot.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. So you got two options to get out of this wedding. Either you shit your pants on site, on purpose,
mm-hmm.
or you bitch slap the bride's mother.
With no explanation or
recourse. No explanation. You just bitch slap her right there. How do you get out of that wedding, Jeremy?
Boy. I'm gonna bitch slap the bride's mom.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I'm gonna do it, and I'm gonna keep staring at her. I'm not gonna just leave after that. I'm gonna be made to leave.
You're gonna back away slowly.
Right. If you shit your pants, there's a strong chance that they'll be like, oh, he got sick, poor guy. And then they'll invite you to the next family wedding or whatever. If you bitch slap the bride's mom, you're not coming to anything
no.
ever again.
Never.
And especially if you do it and like you mean it. I mean, oh, yeah. Just.
Well, a bitch slap is meaning it.
Right.
Yeah.
But I mean, then just stare her down afterwards. I'm going backhand even.
Oh, absolutely.
In fact, I might do the forehand and then follow it with the backhand.
The old Beavis and Butthead move.
Yeah.
Or the Three Stooges move, actually.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
There he goes.
That's true.
Way to fucking just keep that comedy rolling.
Run up it.
Hey. Going
Beavis and Butthead.
All right.
Anyway, thanks. For Christ's sake, here's the thing is the Three Stooges are to us what Beavis and Butthead is to most of our listeners. It's that old.
So?
Most of them don't remember Beavis and Butthead.
They really don't remember the Three Stooges.
No.
TV was in black and white. That must have sucked.
Oh, God. They're everywhere.
Who was it that, God damn it. Who was the comedian that said that, you know.
Kevin James.
You know why women don't like the Three Stooges? Because they're not funny.
That was Yarko Smirnoff.
I don't believe so.
Okay. This question to me is it all depends whose fucking wedding it is.
If yeah, it's Scotty loves weddings.
If it's somebody that I really like.
It's a wedding you want to get out of.
Oh.
That was in the thing.
Oh, I forgot about
it's
that
It's an
part.
Outdoor wedding. It's hot as fuck. You don't want to be there.
Oh, okay.
It's outdoor?
Oh, it's outdoor.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't care if it's indoor or outdoor. Yeah, I don't want to be there.
Yeah, it's hot and you're wearing fucking a suit and slacks. And
okay. Yeah. Okay. So then I have my answer. But do you want to go to the party afterwards?
You don't want to be at that wedding.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
If it means sacrificing the party afterwards, whatever, you got
to
get out of that.
There's shit. Places to drink elsewhere. Uh-huh.
All right. I'm accidentally shitting my pants.
Purposely. You're purposely shitting.
Well, I'm purposefully shitting my pants, but I'm making it look like it's an accident. Like
No. You're like I don't want to be here, and you just... that's it.
I think you got to be.
I don't think you can accident. Oh, it was an act. No, you. They have to know it was done on purpose.
You can't even be sitting down. You got to be standing up, biting your lip, giving it hell.
Yes.
Because you don't even have to shit. And you got to dig deep.
This is like.
And do you, Charles?
Oh, I wouldn't do it if we've gotten to that part. It's almost done.
Dearly
beloved.
If there's any reason these two should not be married, speak up and forever hold your peace.
I'm thinking it, dearly beloved. I'm.
God, this is so stupid. Fucking flowers. Look at the goddamn dresses they're wearing. Shit.
The best part would be dun dun da dun.
Yep, that's me.
Shitting your pants.
I'm shitting my pants. I can't. I couldn't do it. I couldn't slap a woman like that. I couldn't do it.
The deal is.
She's a bitch,
you,
though. I know. That's fine.
If you hit a woman, you're going to be known as a woman beater forever.
That's exactly right.
If you shit your pants, you're always going to be that guy that shit his pants.
Sure.
But, people are going to find out about that.
But shitting your pants on purpose is kind of legendary.
Right.
Sure. In a way. Like, you're not going to believe this. This guy shit his pants on purpose.
Yeah.
And you know what? I think I'm going to be less apt to be invited to different shit.
Yes.
After that, if I shit my pants. Like, if I hit the bridesmaid or the bride's mother, I'm just not going to be invited to hang out with them anymore.
I honestly don't recall the last get-together that I was looked forward to. I mean, like a family thing. If it's not with my friends,
yeah.
I mean, I can't imagine wanting to go back for more. If I can get out of everything permanently,
yeah
I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Well, I think just because what happens if I get invited to another wedding and I got to bitch slap another bridesmaid or bride's mother? So I keep saying bride's mother.
That actually becomes like what you do. That's what you become known for.
So I'm going to go with shit my pants. I think
you got to have Derek at your wedding.
He's
fucking life of the party.
Like, hey, Tommy's graduating next weekend. Oh, wait, we don't want to invite Derek to that. Even the last time when he was at Carol's wedding, He fucking shit himself on purpose because he didn't want to be there.
So somebody was right next to him going, the restrooms are down here. Nope. Too late.
Yeah, it's Jason's third birthday party. I wanted to know, we can't have Derek go to that birthday party.
Yeah, birthday parties are okay.
Kids' birthday parties are
new.
I'm shitting my pants to get out of that. I'm
shitting my pants to get out of
that. I might just start doing that. I know. That might just be my thing.
I know people who will get a keg for every year old their kid is. I know some not very good parents. That's what I'm saying.
That might be my thing. Like, honey, get my brown slacks.
Yeah. Hey, there's a party to go to. Get my shitting pants.
That's going to be my new thing.
All right.
Where are we doing Thanksgiving at this year? Don't you worry about it. I've got it handled. We didn't even bring a side. We're not going to be here long. It's going to be all right.
I'm still slapping Mom.
Nope. Me and Derek are shitting.
I guess you guys are just fucking gentlemen, aren't you?
That's right.
We got chivalry with shit in your pants.
We're poop pals.
That's right. Yeah, because you got to ride home with those pants.
I get
to just ride home knowing I slapped a lady.
Believe me, I am not necessarily worried about driving home with shit in my pants. I'm worried about driving home with shit in my pants with my wife in the car. That's what I'm worried about. Especially if it's one of her friends' weddings. That's what I'm worried about.
She's never smelled your shit.
Nope.
That's
it smells like flowers, Jeremy.
Scotty probably still thinks she doesn't poop.
That she doesn't.
That really is an issue that I have. Not shit in my pants, but
on purpose.
Right.
Yeah.
I have a whole bit on it about how my wife is a little older than I am, so she's right at the age where a lot of her high school friends are getting married again. And she will come up to me like, 2 weeks ahead of time, or maybe just even a week if she gives me that much notice, and be like, you remember my friend Tanya? I don't know. Have you ever talked about her, or have I met her? No, I don't think so. Well, then you're not friends. Maybe you were.
Anyway, she's getting married. You're stepping on my headphone cord. God damn.
Anyways, that actually was my catheter tube.
Was your catheter tube.
Yeah. But yeah, we went to that fucking gay wedding.
Ooh.
Which the couple was straight. The wedding was gay as hell. It was the worst thing. Okay, I hope that they don't listen to this because my wife is still kind of friends with them. But you know how they do that unity candle shit?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's where I'm shitting my pants. They didn't right at the unity candle.
They didn't do that.
What'd they do?
They brought out an easel and did a unity painting.
I would set it on fire with a unity candle.
If there was one, we would have had one.
You gotta be kidding me.
And I don't know what they were trying to paint, but it came out looking like a gargoyle's ball sack. It was awful. And then,
oh Jesus,
cash bar.
Oh, you fuckers.
Cash bar.
Fucking cash bars. All right. Well, that's that's all I got. You guys got anything else?
No.
Other than your gargoyle balls.
No.
The Reverend at the end of the ceremony invited everybody next door to the hall.
Uh-huh.
And the way he put it was perfect just for me to get back at my wife, because he said to go enjoy some food and drinks and to enjoy each other. And so I walked around stroking a long neck going, I sure am enjoying you.
Well done. Well done,
my wife's friends. I tell you what, Scotty, you know how next week's going to go?
Yeah.
Start the show like you're just starting the show.
All right.
Go ahead.
What's up, guys?
Derek, you're excused. You don't have to do this one.
You can get out of here.
Welcome to the...
All right. Well, that's all I got. Anybody got anything else?
Mm-mm.
All right. Guys, we sincerely appreciate it. We love the fact that you guys are starting to share a lot of our stuff. We really do. Please keep commenting, liking all of all the videos. That really helps us out. And keep obviously listening to the podcast. The podcast is on every platform. If you watch us on YouTube and you want to listen to us in our car, you can do that. That's seems to be a lot easier. But
is it on platform 9 3/4?
9 3/4, yes.
Nice.
Yes.
My wife's been
all
watching
all the way to Hogwarts.
Fucking.
It's always on.
Last 2 weeks.
Yeah, it's always on.
But they're doing like a marathon over and over again on Sci-Fi.
Yeah.
But also on those platforms, if you could leave us a 5-star rating, that helps us out even more. But more than anything, we always say you guys are our advertisers. Please do us a favor and keep telling your friends and your family if you like us. But if you don't like us,
we hope you cut your taint shaving and you jump into a bathtub full of lemon juice.
If you don't like us,
tell your enemies.
And until next time, guys,
say it.
Sega!
Until next time.
Keep laughing, assholes.
We will see you later. Take care.